Alrighty, time for round one. I would in fact like to play first. What does this hand do? It doesn't do anything. If I draw a Signet, it's good. If I draw, well, if I draw a Lotus, almost any hand is good. You know, I actually think I keep this. The fact that if I draw like a Channel or a Signet or almost, I mean, even a Thran Dynamo makes this hand okay. There's just a lot of artifact acceleration I could draw, or non-artifact acceleration as, you know, as far as cards like Channel. They make me want to keep it. I'm going to play a Woodland Cemetery first, I believe. Opponent is on 6 cards right now. Alright. Woodland Cemetery, so I can play a turn 2 Channel like if I have Maya Coast. Or if I draw like Remand, I can just play an Island. Thoughtseize, that's not bad. Let's go ahead and cast Thoughtseize. I have the Force Spike, and I'm not going to play around Daze, I don't think. This cube's got lots of dangerous stuff going on, so the sooner you Thoughtseize, the better. Well then, my opponent's hand is a bunch of cards that don't matter, and Shadow Mage is not bad, but I'm going to take the Moldrifter because my opponent's plan is to go Ancient Tomb Moldrifter, and by taking Moldrifter, that will potentially slow them down a decent amount. I'm playing Sun Petal Grove, I look like I'm playing junk, you know, obs on like midrange or something, but little do they know. Ancient Tomb's a nice card. Does mean they probably didn't draw another land, so they can't cast Shadow Mage. Spell Scythe's coming out, that I don't mind too much. Guess I'll just play Wooded Foothills so I can go get my red mana sources. Against what my opponent's got, it's possible that just playing a Jar on turn 5 is going to be good enough. So here I'll get Blood Crypt just because I'd rather get Blood Crypt now than draw it later. Of course not paying the life. Ooh, Library of Alexandria. Interesting, but I think I'm still just going to play a Memory Jar, so I don't really want to play Library right now. I've got some nice lands in play. Imagine if I draw, like, a Mirari's Wake. I guess I'm glad I'm playing that against this particular draw. My opponent's Mold of 6, Thoughtseize, Moldrifter, don't do anything draw. But even if my opponent plays, like, a Shadow Mage now, I mean, so many cards in their hand, like Ultimate Price and Garruk, Apex Predator, are just, like, cards that do absolutely nothing against this deck. I mean, Ultimate Price, sure, kills Goblin Welder. Garruk, I guess, puts Beast into play and maybe kills Goblin Welder, but yeah, I'm not too worried about any of those things. Right now, I think I play the Library. Of course, Jar with Brain Freeze in hand already is a little unfortunate, but even if I set aside these three cards, I could Jar into enough action to set up a, like, I guess I'm cashing back the Jar hand end of turn, so I've got to decide how I want to do this. I guess if my opponent's still just doing absolutely nothing, I can just wait and see what I draw here. Yeah, drawing Brain Freeze is mildly awkward. I guess I could Jar to maybe try to put Bargain into play and then pass the turn with Bargain out. We'll see what I draw. Ooh, Mystical Tutor, what does that do? It could actually, what it could do is get me a Thirst for Knowledge. If I Mystical for Thirst, I can discard Yawgmoth's Will and Brain Freeze to Thirst, and then I can, or no, I guess I can't discard Yawgmoth's Will, that's probably not very smart. let's see. Could crack Jar. Or I could, because the problem is Mystical Link doesn't give me any mana sources. Jar can let me play some lands, play like a Lotus maybe, and set up a turn for next turn. Alright, I'm just going to crack Jar then, I think. And it's not much my opponent can do with it. See, this actually works out pretty well. I can play Lotus. I guess I might as well Library here. I can't actually, I'm one mana short of playing Kozilek just with the Lotus, but if I Library into a Channel, I could do that. All right. Let's suspend Ancestral Visions. Actually, I guess I should have Faithless Looting first because I'm just going to do that anyway. Ooh. Oh, I use the red for Faithless Looting, unfortunately. I guess Kozilek's getting discarded no matter what. And I'm not sacking Lotus to play Goblin Welder, so I'm just going to discard Island, Kozilek, and shuffle now. And then play Golgari Signet, Chromox, Imprint Goblin Welder. My opponent even has a Ultimate Price in hand here. And then play a Lotus. And I already played a land? No, I did not. Land, and then pass the turn, see what my opponent discards here. Discarded Xenagos? I did not expect that. Freylace? Alright, I guess we're just like 5-color control, time twister, or 4-color control. And Druun didn't do anything now, so end of turn I probably mystical for something. Oh, Mana Crypt. Alright, what do we got off this Mana Crypt? Hopefully not a Lodestone Golem. That would be annoying. Alright, Yawgmoth Coast with no picture apparently. Nevenril's Disc. Alright, well, I'm on a 1-turn clock, but I don't think that's going to be too hard to meet here. What am I mysticaling for? I mean, I could just do a card draw spell. I guess on my upkeep, I should mystical. Because I'm not going to need the mana. I have lots of mana. And I want to amp up this Mind's Desire. I mean, Time Spiral's good. Actually, Remand could be good. Channel could be interesting. Thirst, Faithless Looting, Factor Fiction. Because all I want to do is set up a good Brain Freeze. So it could be that, like, I mystical for Remand. I sack Lotus. I cast Brain Freeze. I cast Remand on it. Sack Lotus, cast Brain Freeze, cast Remand, cast Yawgmoth's Will. Yeah, that's going to be like millions of cards. Just hope my opponent doesn't have an Eldrazi. I guess we'll play a land. We'll sack this for blue. So, let's Brain Freeze my opponent. Tapping, I suppose, Sun Petal Grove. Remand the Brain Freeze. Ooh, of course, now I draw Mirari's Wake. it's okay, I don't need to pay 5 to add 5 mana. So Brain Freeze, still haven't seen any like Eldrazi's or anything like that, which is good. And then I tap, I'm just going to cast Brain Freeze. Yeah, this is just millions of Brain Freezes here. I actually almost don't need the Yawgmoth's Will, but I'm going to cast it up. Because, well, I do actually need it, but I almost didn't need it. Because now I get to Brain Freeze my opponent for 12, and then cast Yawgmoth's Will, then play Lotus, yeah. Alright, looks like no Eldrazi, so I can keep the Brain Freeze plan going. Could be something like Force Spike or Vendilion Click. I guess I have Remain and Thoughtseize as a disruption already, and I don't think I need much more than that.